why come to McMaster? As I was walking around meeting a bunch of you, I was saying, look, every school that you're interested in has the same textbook. You're going to get basically the same courses, plus or minus. So where are you going to choose to go? So I have a BCom degree, major in accounting from the University of Toronto, a couple of generations ago. I've been just reappointed as a dean here. Nobody wants me to retire. I think my wife drove that. I want to talk about three things: excellence, culture, and innovation. Let me preface it by 10 days ago was an event on innovation led by Gowling's law firm in downtown Hamilton. And I was talking to someone, the group, and he said, anyone here have a 2-year-old child or grandchild? And a number of hands went up. Because he was trying to explain how the world is changing. He said, when they turn 16, they're going to look at you. They're going to look at you, the 17-year-olds that are rooting. They're going to say, you actually drove? Think of that. The rite of passage that everybody in this room went through. Can't wait to get my driver's license. That's going to be a different world. Self-driving vehicles, why drive? So we have to prepare you for that kind of world. And the world of augmented intelligence, machine learning, blockchain, these are all elements that have to be part of any education these days in business. I've talked to several of you who, like me, want to go into accounting. What's accounting in 5 years? What's going to be the world of accounting? Auditing, we still has a firm coming in who want to talk about their new work in auditing. I used to do some auditing. What is auditing? You sample the firm's transactions and then give an opinion on the entire set of books. Why sample? The machine can do every transaction in 2.2 seconds and then tell you flat out the ones you should be looking at. That's the world of auditing. So we have to prepare you for that. So McMaster, first excellence. How many of you know the top, there are 4 Canadian universities in the world top 100? Those universities are in order if you do the Shanghai Jiao Tong rankings. Our University of Toronto, University of British Columbia, McMaster, and then McGill. And McMaster is the 66th best university in the world. There are 20,000 universities. And Times Higher Education, these are the rankings that every university in the world looks at. And the Times Higher Education, McGill is ahead of us, but still it's University of Toronto, University of British Columbia, McGill, and there McMaster is the 78th best university in the world. The most research-intensive university in Canada is McMaster, not University of Toronto. Look at the difference in size. But research dollars per capita, nobody touches McMaster. And that's a differentiator, because you want to be at a university which is looking to the future and working on new ideas. So in terms of research, you want to be at a university where that is paramount. Because think of the world you're going into for your jobs. You want to have an understanding of that. With all due respect to Ivy, what are cases? Why do you want to look at IBM in 2005? You want to go into what we're going to be doing called discovery. You want to work with students from other faculties in discovering new ideas. Second big thing is culture. I've been too many places. So I've taught at University of Toronto. I was a dean in Calgary. I've taught at both INSEAD and London Business School in the world. Top 5 business schools. What's unique about McMaster, and why I love sustained here is its culture. I remember my daughter, my younger daughter, went to McGill for a degree in math. And she phoned me after the first year and said, I can't survive on math. I said, what are you going to do? She said, well, I'm going to do an anthropology. I guess my voice went, really, anthropology? And in a deep voice, she said to me, you're a business school guy. Ain't you ever heard about culture? So culture really counts. As I said, everybody's got the same textbooks. But what's your class like? This is a community. It's not a harsh environment. So this may not be good for you. You may be a really competitive person who really wants to, ace, be number one, and be with other people like you. This may be, I'm not sure we're like that. Or we're very community driven. That's McMaster's motto, interdisciplinary community. So that's cultures, I think, is a good reason to be here. We collaborate, we're very interdisciplinary. The reason I came here, they said we work hugely with the medical school. The only place in the world where a business school and a medical school work together. We have something called the Health Leadership Academy with $10 million from Michael G. DeGroote to integrate business solutions into health issues. Innovation. McMaster is known for problem-based learning. Yesterday we had an away day with our faculty where we had the Dean of Engineering talking about machine learning. We had two people from the Blockchain Research Institute, which is headquartered in Hamilton, talking about the blockchain. And we had one of our great grads, a guy called Alfredo Tan, who was marketing director for Facebook and started Facebook in Southeast Asia, who's now the chief innovation officer for WestJet. Good luck, Alfredo. talking about analytics. And this is what we want to, this is what we bring into the classroom. This is why the research is so important to your future and make sure it's in the classroom. We're launching this fall joint with engineering and an innovation minor. It's going to be open to everybody across the university. So for students in history and philosophy, everybody can do an innovation in minor. We have joined a program with engineering at Stanford called the Digital Cities Project. We're the only university with Stanford on this project with a number of firms looking at these significant issues like privacy, like what's the business model? When you look at what Alphabet or Google wants to do with downtown Toronto, you really want to live there? What's the business model for that kind of venture? How do you design it so it's people friendly as well? As being Alphabet friendly. We have a course called Innovation by Design that we run with IBM. We're honoring, we have an annual Alumnus of the Year. Our Alumnus of the Year on May 24th is a guy called Dino Fravassani, BCom, DeGroote, Chair of IBM Canada, on the board, Executive Board of IBM Worldwide, just moved to be main guy in banking in Europe for IBM. And finally, what I want to talk about is this. What we're unveiling today is a new building. A new building that, when you go over to the Groot, is a design for something called Innes Library that's next to the Groot. That's a 1.5-story building. That's being replaced by a 7-story glass structure that does not have a faculty office in it. The dean does not have the penthouse. The penthouse is for students. The entire building is for students. The building is going to be designed, won't be ready for 4 years. But if you take an exchange year, or not trying to convince you to do this, or an internship, you'll be your last year and you'll be in the building. But you're here to help us design it. It's not designed as yet. We have a shell, we know it's on the first 3 floors. We don't know what's on the rest of it. But it's for students, it is open space, it's collaboration space. We're working with every other faculty. For example, there'll be a floor on for entrepreneurship. You can only get in the floor with your root ID, but you have to be with a student, at least one student from another faculty. You gotta work with others. And we're already changing our programs for next year, so that in 4 years, we're not waiting 4 years to redesign things. The future is now. We can't wait. We gotta start redesigning what we do today for you, and continue designing it as you're here.